Here it is. The Divine Syndicate is not a supplier to Kew Gardens. Besides, there is no address here. Here it is. Locked. Mr. Hamish, can you explain to us what happened to the colonial collection? It seems somewhat depleted.
But most likely maintenance work, tidying up.
You're not sure then? But you're the deputy director.
Well, I am busy. I cannot be everywhere at once.
As deputy director, how was your relationship with Montague Dunn?
To be honest with you, Mr. Holmes, it could have been better. You see, every Tuesday he would carry out his inspection of the gardens, but it was solely to make an impression, great pretense that he cared at all. He would give out absurd orders, ignoring anyone else's opinion. He would then disappear for the rest of the week. He was what some might call a man of action. I'd say rather he was overzealous and chaotic. So after all, it was no wonder, perhaps, that he ended up like that, if you take into consideration his kind of lifestyle.
You mentioned that Mr. Dunn led a particular lifestyle.
Well, it's no secret that he enjoyed celebrating, shall we say. He was a member of the London Smart Set. He was famous for it. That and...
And?
He had an eye for the ladies, to put it mildly, Mr. Holmes.
Mr. Hamish, can you tell us who holds the keys to the locked greenhouses?
That would be Albert, Mr. Dunn's son. Yes, Albert keeps all the keys, and one can only imagine why.
What do you mean?
Well, he was never interested in Kew Gardens before. And now, all of a sudden, he is trying to act as if he owns the place. I think he wants to take over the management here. He'd do better to leave that to me. He has no experience. No, none at all.
Tell me, Mr. Hamish, do you grow the more deadly variety of plant here?
You mean insectivorous? Yes, but nothing larger than that.
Are you aware of the Divine Syndicate?
The Divine what? Is this a joke?
No, I am quite serious.
What a ridiculous name. Anyway, I have never heard of this syndicate.
Thank you, Mr. Hamish. We shall continue our investigation.
Can I help you, gentlemen?
Who is Miss Margaret White?
Ah, she is the young lady who studies with me. She visits here sometimes to help out with the greenhouses. In fact, she should be here today. She wanted to work at the seed house. That's the small greenhouse across from the large glasshouse.
Do you work here?
Yes, but part-time only, for I'm also studying botany at the University of London.
You're following in your father's footsteps, then that is commendable.
Well, even if botany is not my strongest suit, there are people who say that I could be a good manager.
We noticed that a part of the colonial collection has been cleared.
Ah. At the moment, I'm just dealing with the storage room. I don't know much about the other rooms.
I imagine that your relationship with your father may have been a strained one.
Yes. I cannot say that he was a kind man, for he never listened to me at all. He forced me to work here. But now, after his death, I've been pondering it over. Perhaps he wasn't so wrong about me after all. I have to follow his path, and I have to manage Kew Gardens. And I can do it. I can be as good as any other who works here.
Would you please tell us about Martin Hamish, the deputy director?
Well, I have to tell you that Mr. Hamish is not and has never been the deputy director of Kew Gardens. My father would not have tolerated it.
Indeed? That is most interesting. He told us that he was.
Yes, because he believes that the management should be passed down to him now that my father is dead. But in actual fact, Mr. Hamish only has the honor of being the garden's longest-serving employee. In fact, if we are to think logically at all, it should be me who takes over the management of Kew Gardens.
Do you not have a good relationship with Mr. Hamish?
I suppose so. But we have very little in common. Mr. Hamish loves his plants and Kew Gardens, and I cannot say that I share his passion.
I see. And how was his relationship with your father?
Oh, he hated my father. It was obvious. He would be furious whenever my father boasted of Kew Gardens in the newspapers or at conferences. He was convinced that my father was stealing all of the credit for himself. But my father treated Mr. Hamish in the same way as he treated anyone. Dismissively. With indifference.
Tell me, have you ever heard of the Divine Syndicate?
No, I cannot say that I have.
Do you hold the keys to all of these locked doors?
Yes, you can have them. But I cannot give you the keys to the cloakroom. The employees' effects are private. I am sure you understand.
Thank you, young man. We shall see you again soon. Locked. Newspapers discussing Kew Gardens. Photograph of Montague Dunn and Reynold Hamish.